lecturer part 3 on operational research. So in the previous video we have discussed about the introduction to operational research and some brief history of OR and the phases, characteristics and advantages and limitations of the operational research. So in the today's class we will be dealing with the how to formulate the linear programming problem. So this is one illustration I have taken. This is the first example in your textbook. So I will read it once. A small scale industry produces 3 rubber products. These products are processed on 3 different machines. The time required to manufacture 1 unit of each of the 3 products and the daily capacity of the 3 machine is given in the table below. So here is a table. So here there are 3 kinds of a rubber products are there that we need to manufacture and sell, and there are 3 machines. Its capacity is given. So no, machine capacity minutes per day, that is 440 minutes in a day we can use machine M1, and 420 minutes we can use a machine M2, and M3 can be used for a 430 minutes a day. And the product 1 requires 2 minutes of time on machine M1 to operate and process it. Okay. And product 2 requires 3 minutes of time on machine M1, and product 3 requires 2 minutes on machine M1, and similarly the machine M2 time and machine M3 time. So this is the table. Okay. So now it is required to determine the daily number of units to be manufactured for each product. The profit per unit for a product 1, 2, 3 are 4 rupees, 3 rupees and 6 rupees respectively. Okay. So in this problem, we need to find out how many quantities of product 1, product 2 and product 3 we need to manufacture. How many quantities we need to manufacture. And so product 1 will yield you 4 rupees profit, product 2 yield 3 rupees profit, and product 3 yield 6 rupees profit. So based on these conditions we need to formulate the linear programming problems. Okay. So now so there are 4 steps required to solve any kind of a linear programming problems. So first one is to define the decision variables x1, x2, x3. Okay. So here what is the meaning of decision variables? So decision variables are those variables for which the value we need to find out. So in this problem, okay, as I have mentioned the problem where we need to find out how many quantities of product 1, product number 2 and 3 we need to manufacture. So that is why let us consider these products as a decision variables. One more thing you remember, decision variables are those variables which are directly dependent on the profit. So profit is related to product 1, product 2, product 3 is given here. Okay. So these are the profits given. Hence this becomes a decision variables. Okay. So we'll write it down. So let x1 is a decision variable for a number of units. Number of units for a product number 1. Product 1 means we need to find out how many quantities of this product 1 we need to manufacture and sell to get a profit. Right? And next one is the decision variable x2. So let it be number of units for a product number 2. Again, how many quantity we need to manufacture and sell the product 2 we need to find out. And next one is x3, that is number of units for a product number 3. So there are 3 products, hence the decision variables are x1, x2 and x3. So coming to the second point, second step, that is to formulate the objective function. So here objective function is to maximizing the profit. So whenever in the problem, if it is mentioned about the profit, you need to maximize it. Whenever a costs are given, we need to minimize it. Because every organization or industry requires maximizing the profit and minimizing the losses. Okay, so that's why here profits are mentioned. Hence, we need to maximize the profit. Hence, here the objective function is to maximize. Then what to maximize? Listen carefully. So here, product 1 requires 2 minutes of time. Or else, you better take X1. So here, X1 is the number of units for a product 1. Okay. And if we manufacture one quantity of X1, we will get a profit 4 rupees. So here we have a 4 rupees profit, here we have a 3 rupees profit, and here we have 6 rupees profit. So if we manufacture and sell one quantity of X1, we get 4. Means if we manufacture X1 number of quantities, we will get 4 times X1 profit. Okay. Similarly, if we manufacture and sell X2 number of quantities, we get 3 times X2, because for every product we are getting 3 rupees profit. Okay, so that's why our objective function Z, it is denoted as Z, we need to maximize the Z, that is 4 times X1 plus 3 times X2 plus 6 times X3. So this is the objective function. So here we need to maximize whenever the profits are given. Whenever the costs are given, you need to minimize it. Okay. So coming to the third step, that is to formulate the other conditions. So it is also nothing but restrictions or constraints, we can say. So here the constraints is what? Definitely it is a machine capacity. Because here they have mentioned only we have to use 440 minutes per day, the machine 1 we can use, and machine 2 we can use it only for 420 minutes, not beyond that. So these are the restrictions. We need to consider this also. Listen carefully. The product 1 requires 2 minutes, product 2 requires 3 minutes, and product 3 requires 2 minutes. So in one set of manufacturing the 3 products, we require 2 plus 3, 5 plus 2, 7 minutes of time. So in that way, within 440 minutes, how many quantities of product 1, product 2 and product 3 we can manufacture? So that is what the restriction is. Okay. So here I will take 2x1 plus 3 times x2 plus 2 times product 3 is nothing but what? X3, no? So it is 2x3. This is less than or is equal to 440 minutes. Clear? So if we manufacture x1 number of quantities, we require 2 times x1 minutes of time. If we manufacture x2 number of quantities, we require 3 times of x2 time. Similarly, if we manufacture x3 number of quantities, we require 2 times x3 time. So total time for a machine 1 is what? 440. We have to use it up to 440 minutes of time or less than 440 minutes of time. This is what the condition or restriction we can say. Similarly, we can go for machine M2, that is 4x1 plus, here product 2 doesn't require machine M2. So directly 3 times x3. This is less than or is equal to 420 minutes of time. And similarly, 2 times x1 plus 5 times x2. Product 3 doesn't require machine M3. So it is less than or is equal to 430 minutes of time. So these are the restrictions. And the last step is non-negativity condition. So here we are manufacturing the product 1, 2, 3 definitely more than 0 or more than 1. So that's why you have to say x1 is greater than or is equal to 0, x2 is greater than or is equal to 0, and x3 is also greater than or is equal to 0. This is non-negativity condition. Okay. And finally, we have to sum it up and we have to write the formalization of the linear programming problems. That is, first you need to write the maximizing the profit. That is objective function you need to write. That is the same thing. 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 6x3. Subjected to the constraints, that is these three. 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 2x3 is less than or is equal to 440. And second point, 4x1 plus 3x3 is less than or is equal to 420. And last one, 2x1 plus 5x2 is less than or is equal to 430. And the subjected to non-negativity condition also, that is x1 greater than or is equal to 0, x2 greater than or is equal to 0, and x3 greater than or is equal to 0. So this is the formulation of the linear programming problem.